वेलकम स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज 14th लेक्चर ऑफ रिप्रोडक्शन इन लोअर एंड हायर एनिमल्स। इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट द प्रोसेस ऑफ प्रेगनेंसी एंड प्लासेंटेशन। व्हाट इज प्रेगनेंसी? प्रेगनेंसी इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज गेस्टेशन। इट इज द कंडीशन ऑफ कैरिंग वन और मोर एम्ब्रियोज इन द यूटेरस एंड इट इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज गेस्टेशन। The period of pregnancy is in between fertilization and parturition. What is fertilization? Fusion of male and female gamete so as to form a zygote is called as fertilization. And after fertilization, cleavages and growth of embryo occurs. And at last, parturition occurs, that is delivery of the baby occurs after the 9th month of the pregnancy. So this period is in between fertilization and parturition. The average period of pregnancy in a human is last for 266 days from fertilization or 280 days from last menstrual cycle. Why? Last menstrual cycle shows presence of 14th day up to the ovulation. All these 14th day plus 260 days including forms 280 days period from this last menstrual cycle. This is approximately 9 months. Entire pregnancy period is in case of human being is approximately 9 months and is again divided into 3 trimesters. See here again, these 3 trimesters are in consist of 3 months in each trimester. First trimester includes period from fertilization up to the 12th week, that is first 3 months. Then second trimester includes the period in between 13th week of the after fertilization up to the 26th week of the fertilization. This is the second trimester. And third trimester includes period from 27th week after fertilization up to the parturition or delivery. Then again see first trimester, it is the period starts from the fertilization and ends with the 12th week of the embryo. In this trimester, embryo receives nutrient directly from the endometrium. It is the main period of organ formation and development. By the end of 8th week, major organs are formed in embryo and it is in rudimentary form. Now, this embryo is called as fetus. Up to now, we have called that it is embryo, but now from this phase, it is called as fetus. It is about 3 cm long. In this period, central nervous system is fully formed. In this first trimester, the central nervous system is fully formed. Working of circulatory as well as excretory system also begins. Heartbeat can be heard from the 6th week of the embryo. And in this phase, the progesterone level get increases. In case of mother, the menstrual cycle is completely ceases or stopped up to the pregnancy. During pregnancy, menstrual cycle does not occurs. And now the fetus is about 7 to 10 centimeter long. The mother's body shows various changes, that is increases level of progesterone. And maternal part of the placenta also grows during this first trimester and uterus becomes larger. Mother experiences morning sickness, that is nausea, vomiting and mood swings. These are the various changes also occurs in the mother's body, that is enlargement of the uterus and morning sickness, that is feeling of nausea and vomiting also occurs in this first trimester. After first trimester, the pregnancy enters into the second trimester. It includes the period in between 13th week up to the 26th week. It is the period of rapid growth of the fetus. In this period, growth of fetus occurs. Fetus becomes highly active during this period. It grows about 30 cm in length. To accommodate the growing baby, mother's uterus is also grows in size. Hormones level stabilizes as human chorionic gonadotropic hormone declines and corpus luteum becomes degenerated and placenta produces the progesterone which maintains the pregnancy. So the function of corpus luteum is shifted towards the placenta
बिफोर दैट कॉर्पस ल्यूटियम सिक्रेट्स प्रोजेस्टेरोन हार्मोन, बट फ्रॉम दिस फेज द कॉर्पस ल्यूटियम गेट डीजनरेटेड एंड द प्लासेंटा प्रोड्यूसेस प्रोजेस्टेरोन हार्मोन व्हिच इज वेरी रिक्वायर्ड फॉर द मेंटेनेंस ऑफ प्रेगनेंसी. देन बेबीज मूवमेंट्स कैन बी सीन इन दिस ट्राइमिस्टर एंड हेयर्स ऑन द हेड आईब्रोज आई लैशेस आर ऑल्सो फॉर्म्ड इन दिस ट्राइमिस्टर. बेबी रीचेस द हाफ साइज ऑफ द न्यूबॉर्न. In this trimester, baby grows and forms the half of the size of up to of the newborn. Then third trimester, from 27th week till the parturition, third trimester is located. The fetus grows about 3 to 4 kg in weight and 50 cm in length. In this trimester, eyes are open. See here, in this trimester, the eyes of fetus are open, uterus expands fully and mother's abdominal organs get compressed and also displaced. Due to enlargement of the uterus, other abdominal organs are compressed and also displaced. Frequent urination occurs because of the displacement as well as compression of these organs. Digestive blockage or back strains are also the common problems in this trimester in the mother's body. Now, fetus is fully formed and ready for parturition. In this trimester, fetus is fully formed and it is ready for parturition or delivery. Now, we get into the formation of placenta. What is placenta? Placenta is the temporary structural and functional connection in between fetal and maternal circulation. So what is placenta? Placenta is the connection in between fetus and mother's uterus. Here circulation occurs with this connection, therefore it is the connection in between fetal and maternal circulation. It is flat discoidal organ in the uterus of pregnant woman which attaches to the baby's umbilical cord. So baby's umbilical cord connected with the uterus of the mother by this placenta. See here in this diagram, this is the organ which is present in between fetus and uterine endometrium. Through this placenta, connection occurs and it also supplies nutrient as well as food material to the baby and receives unwanted material from the baby by this placenta. Then what is the role of placenta? It supplies oxygen nutrient to the fetus. Baby receives oxygen and nutrient from the mother's body by this placenta, as well as this placenta also remove the carbon dioxide and excretory waste material from the fetus. So fetus, in the body of the fetus, the excretory waste material also produced as well as carbon dioxide, that is end product of respiratory system, is also produced, and all these unwanted material get received by the mother's body by using this placenta. Then this placenta also produces hormones, that is human chorionic gonadotropin hormone as well as progesterone hormone, which are very important for the maintenance of the pregnancy and growth of the fetus during pregnancy. See in this diagram, it is the placenta formed from two different individuals, that is mother and fetus. This placenta is formed from two different individuals. One individual is baby and another individual is mother's uterus. From these two individuals, the placenta is formed. Fetal placenta originated from fetus. See here, from this umbilical cord. This is umbilical cord. From this umbilical cord, fetus placenta is originated. And it is in the form of chorionic villi. All these are the villi formed from extra embryonic membrane, that is chorion. See here, this is chorion. It is extra embryonic membrane. From this extra embryonic membrane, the villi structure is formed and it is called as chorionic villi. Then maternal placenta is in the formed from the uterine wall and which is rich in supply of blood. See, this is the wall of uterus, that is endometrium, innermost wall of the uterus, and from this uterus the placenta is developed. So endometrium, which is highly vascular layer of the uterus, and chorionic villi of the fetus, both togetherly forms this organ called as placenta. So human placenta is called as hemochorion.
the simone placenta is called as hemochorial. Placenta also acts as an endocrine gland. This placenta plays an important role, that is, it also acts as an endocrine gland and produces progesterone hormone during pregnancy, which is required for the maintenance of pregnancy. So in this lecture we have studied the process of pregnancy, different periods of the pregnancy. In addition to this, also the structure of placenta and role of placenta. Thank you.